In this video, let's talk about how to create a raw data view to help you to avoid losing data. Now, what we're talking about here is in the actual view section itself. So in your admin screen, we're gonna go over to the view. And here you've got typically, when you first start out, you're gonna see all website data. This is the original view that you have. But what happens sometimes is people will come into this view and that's all they have. They just have that one view and they might create goals. So they would have goals in here. They might create filters in here. And the problem is, in this case, there is a filter that's set up. The problem with that is if you just have one view and you have this filter is only allowing YouTube traffic to come in, which is fine. But if you ever wanted to see the other pages, you never can, because if you only have one view with this filter, you'll never see the other pages ever. And that could be a problematic thing. So all you would need to do is you want to come in here, you'll see an ability to actually add a new view, and you would add a new view. And then once you do that, leave it alone. Don't have any filters or any goals added to it. Just call it your backup data view. And at that point, it will be your raw data view that you can keep in case of emergency only. It's not a view that you would normally want to use or keep around, other than the fact of if something goes horribly wrong, you accidentally filter out data for, again, for example, maybe you wanted to see the other pages that were coming in, you would have that view to be able to do that. And it's always, always, always a good idea. It's kind of one of those things that you must do. Make sure you create a backup data view. Make sure there are no goals, there are no filters associated to that view. And again, if you don't have that, just click on create new view and that's it. So we'll say this is our backup and that's it. You set it up and you're done. Leave it alone at that point. In fact, a little pro tip here, if I go to view settings, I'll show you. I like doing this. So we'll say z_backup, save it. I'm not touching anything else. I'm not adjusting anything else in it. It's just collecting data. And if I come back here, I'm just gonna do a real quick refresh and you'll be able to see that in the view now, it's actually because of the z_, it's alphabetical. So it'll show up at the bottom and it's unlikely that anybody will use it because it's always at the bottom, which is where you want it. It's only there in case of emergency. If you mess up everything else, you can always come back to this one and see at least the data that that was collecting at that period of time. All right, now it is your turn. I would love to hear how you're actually applying what you're learning to your own business. So do me a favor, leave a comment below. And also, if you like topics around Google Analytics, be sure to like and subscribe to this channel. You're going to love the other future videos and you will actually be notified when they're released, assuming you subscribe.